Margaret, that's a pizza menu. Why are you putting it with replacement windows?
I'm tired. We've been doing this for hours.
Exactly. And once we've got all these sorted, we'll never have to do it again. And then anytime anything comes through the door, we'll be able to put it in the relevant box.
Oh, I don't know why we have to save all this rubbish. We know the restaurants we like and we always order the same thing.
What about backup? Chefs change. Places go under. And some of these we've never tried. Look, Poppy Seed House. Soup City. Now look here. Just fritters.
But we don't need to keep four copies of the same leaflets.
No, we just keep two copies. I explained that. Anyway, food is only one category. We've got plumbers here, decorators, roofers, lawn shampooing. Oh, look at this. Massive reductions at that snooty kids' clothing shop, Little Devils. Must be going out of business.
Little Devils? Oh, that's a shame. The owner's such a nice lady.
How do you know?
Oh, I just browse in there sometimes. Oh, look, this could be fun. Chestnut Road Community Festival. They need volunteers. I could bake some cakes.
Don't get involved. Remember what happened with the Neighbourhood Watch? They all turned on you when you voted against the curfew idea.
Oh, it wouldn't be like that.
Well, they're bound to be fanatics. It would probably end in a suicide pact. Anyway, you won't have time. Our evenings are so full already.
Oh, yes, I can't wait to see what you've got lined up for us tomorrow. Maybe we could arrange all our tins and jars so the labels face the front.
Oh. Well, that might be an idea.
Well, I'm going to ring up the community festival and volunteer for cake making.
Hello, hello, intrepid cake maker. What can I offer you? High pressure sales technique or unmolested browsing?
Oh, hello.
Ingredients to the left, decorations to the right. I hope it's not a wedding cake because I'm absolutely out of plastic grooms, but I've got a lovely chocolate pen set for prenuptial agreement.
Do you have any shopping baskets?
All my flour is unbleached. If you want it bleached, just add a drop of lavatory cleaner to the mixture. An old wartime trick. You won't remember powdered egg. Dear me, imagine making cakes without real eggs. And if we wanted icing, we had to melt the saucepan down and pour it over. Some people have railings, but I found them rather dark and trickly. Did you see Little Devils burnt down last night?
No. What?
That children's clothing shop. Terrible. Poor Valerie. She gave her heart and soul to the shop. She must be devastated. My accountant says I should diversify into confectionery, but then I'd be in competition with Sweet Dreams two doors up. He's already had to diversify into milk and newspapers, and that's had a knock-on effect for nothing but newspapers on the corner. Oh! £49.23 new pennies, please. Do pop in again. Tell me how you got on. I love to hear what happens to my bits and bobs. One gets very attached to stock, you know.
Thank you. What's going on? I'm innocent. I'm innocent. It was just a mistake. My hands were full. It wasn't my fault.
No, it's never the criminal's fault, is it, Margaret? Always someone else's fault.
Oh, this is stupid. I've got to go back to work.
Oh, you won't be going back to work for a very long time. You won't be seeing your husband. You won't be seeing your kids.
I haven't got any kids.
Okay, you won't be seeing your pets.
Oh, but I only stole... I mean, I accidentally stole a few sprinkles.
A few? There must be hundreds and thousands of these things. All right. I'm going to leave you for a little while, and I want you to have a think.
Hello. Cigarette?
I don't smoke.
Oh, really? That leaves me a bit stumped. Mm. Are you sure I can't pop to the shops and get you a nicotine patch?
No.
Cigar?
No.
All right. Okay, just give me a minute to remember what comes next.
Well, I wouldn't mind a sandwich. I haven't had any lunch.
Well, I can't do that, Margaret. I'd like to, but my hands are tied. Now, if you cooperate, I can get you all the sandwiches you want. But you have to help me. Otherwise, Charlie's going to come back in here. And by now, he'll have had a few. Actually, he's a lot nicer after a couple of drinks. Loosens up, you know. Oh, I shouldn't have said that, probably. Do you want some tea?
Yes, please.
Good, you see. I'm gaining your confidence with small, humane gestures. It also makes you need to use the lavatory, which is a useful bribe later on. Quite clever. Now, I want you to think about what I've said. She's ready, Charlie.
Well, that was quick. I'll get the confession form.
No. Ready for a cup of tea. Do you mind? I'd get it, only I go off duty now.
But, well, I can't take it in. I don't do good cop.
It's easy. Put your jacket on, soften your voice. Maybe your hair's a little severe. So, yeah, that looks good.
No, it'll never work. She'll still know it's me.
Maybe Caroline could take it in. Caroline!
So in the most sympathetic voice, I said, we need you to come with us to identify your husband's body.
Tea in interview room 3, please.
All right. And if the head turns up, I'll get someone to pop round with it. Give us a hand, Barry, will you?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, thanks.
Bye, Gov.
Bye. Anything, Charlie?
Oh, she'll crack, but then what? Slick lawyer, bleeding heart magistrate, a small fine and she's back on the street. Anything on the shop fire?
Forensic boys say it was definitely petrol. They found some sort of can device.
What kind of sick terrorist mind would do that to a children's shop?
God knows. An insurance company investigator snooping round the place. Reckons he might turn up something our boys missed. College boys.
No sign of forced entry. No battery in the smoke detector.
Faraday is doing an offender profile of the little devil's bomber. Do you like that name? I think it sounds a bit limp. What about Kiddie Clothes Firestorm Jackal? Anyway, take a look.
I've put in all the data about the incident. It appears we're looking for someone middle-aged and of medium height with a tendency to burn things.
Someone sick enough to destroy a woman's valuable stock of highly insured designer children's clothes. Someone twisted. Someone who hates children.
A childless woman, Guff?
Oh, yes. Someone so desperate, so jealous that she can't stomach the thought of decent family folks spending their hard-earned cash on some fancy children's wear.
Well, I've got her, Guff. Come and have a look. Oi, Guff. Some bloke at the front desk. Vital new evidence about a shop fire. It mean anything to you?
Not now.
Yeah, Sarge, I think I know her. From a neighbourhood watch group. Kicking up about civil liberties she was.
I bet she was. Take a look through the two-way, Guff.
They always look so innocent, don't they?
What did you get out of her, Charlie?
Nothing. Cool as a cucumber. Complete professional.
They say the women are often the most ruthless.
Let her go.
What?
What?
Drop all charges and place her under 24-hour surveillance. She'll strike again. So far, all we've got on her is a little shop with an embarrassing name. Let her torch a few warehouses, and that's when we make our move. And we can watch our Mrs. Fish here turn this little cop shop into the toughest anti-terror unit in the country.
Yeah, good, nice one.
Like the sound of that, yeah.
Oh, it was terrible. I felt like some kind of common criminal. Do I look like a thief?
Not to me, you don't, sweetheart.
Good. He's opened the window. Get the parabolic mic.
Okay.
Oh, I should make a complaint.
You should never have got involved with that community thing. Then you'd never have gone to the cake place and never have stolen the hundreds and thousands.
I didn't steal them.
Whatever.
Oh, I should have known I'd get no support from you. If you'd have helped me with the shopping, I wouldn't have got in such a mess in the first place.
Well, it's not my fault you got arrested. You should be more careful.
Oh, it's no use. Can't hear a thing. Let's go.
Oh, sorry.
Morning, sir. Care for an ice cream?
It was a bit early, but, well, why not, yeah. Hey! Oh, what's going on?
Let's start again, shall we?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Bob, understand me. It's not you we're interested in. I don't know what kind of sexual spell she holds you under, but we don't think you're part of her terrorist activities. That's why we want to help you.
Well, how is putting my wife in jail going to help me? Apart from the obvious things, you know, like more freedom and extra cupboard space.
By helping her, she needs help. Help that only long-term care in an inhuman prison regime can provide.
You admit your wife has been showing dissatisfaction with her life. She might be broody, even jealous of people with kids.
Oh, that's not evidence.
Bob, your wife may be a terrorist.
Or a freedom fighter. It depends on your perspective.
Oh, that's ridiculous. Margaret's no criminal. How can I prove it to you?
Get some tea, Charlie.
What's he doing now?
Talking to the mirror for some reason.
What kind of wire?
A listening device.
Will it hurt?
You won't even know you're wearing it.
I didn't know he had a wire.
It's in that IKEA storage unit above the plastic bullets.
We've got plastic bullets.
Hang on. You want me to spy on my own wife?
If you don't mind.
Oh, this is ridiculous.
Look, Bob, I don't believe for one second that your wife is guilty.
You don't?
No.
Well, neither do I, obviously. All I meant was...
But I need to be able to exclude her as a possible suspect.
Right. So if you record a conversation between me and my wife and she says nothing incriminating...
That'll exonerate her and you'll have nothing to worry about.
Oh, but it's the lying, the betrayal of trust. I mean, doing this behind her back. We've always been completely honest.
She won't know.
Okay, then. And then if, when... She doesn't incriminate herself, she's in the clear, yeah?
Exactly.
Oh, it feels really strange. I'll never hide anything from Margaret.
Well, when it's all over, you can explain.
You must be joking. I'm not telling her anything. She'd kill me. Metaphorically.
If you want, we can offer you witness relocation.
No, it's all right, thanks. I already live anonymously in the suburbs.
Now, the important thing is not to fold your arms across your chest because the mic is in this tightly and you'll cover it up.
Actually, this is all pretty exciting. It's like being in a movie.
This isn't a joke, Mr. Fish.
Oh.
And this equipment is very expensive.
We could have got a new photocopier instead of that thing.
Or a fax machine that uses plain paper.
Yeah, and even some plants in here. It'd make it a bit nicer.
Hey, what about protection?
What protection?
Well, you can't expect me to go in there unarmed. I should be packing some heat.
Bob, a firearm in untrained hands is a potentially dangerous weapon.
That's true. Remember when Charlie shot that bloke who was holding a starting pistol?
How was I to know? It was a sack race. I had my kids to protect. Oi, Gov, that bloke from the insurance company's on the phone again. Still on about vital evidence he's uncovered or something.
Tell him I'm not here. Everyone's off on a secret operation or something at a secret location somewhere.
Right. Say a few words, Bob.
Oh, okay. Men, I have to warn you before we undertake this mission that...
Okay. We're all set.
Let's do it. Good luck, Bob.
And this is the AK-47, the weapon of choice when you absolutely, positively have to kill every mother...
Margaret!
Oh!
Down, doggies!
Where have you been? I'm trying to get everything done and nothing works around here.
Yeah, I know. Margaret, I want you to know I love you and trust you.
What do you mean?
I mean, I'm sorry. Sorry for not being more supportive.
Yes, well, you should try getting arrested. It's not much fun being interrogated, you know, and being shouted at by some fat, sweaty idiot with smelly armpits.
He's not that bad.
How do you know?
I don't.
Cheeky cow. I haven't got smelly armpits, have I?
Yeah. What's that thing on your tie?
She's onto him.
Shh! Oh, this. It's a tie pin. Yeah, it's a present. From an amorous female patient.
What?
Not amorous, no, what's the word? Grateful. Yes, I saved her son's life. Tooth. You know how people get carried away, hey? Look, I'm sorry. Let me give you a hand.
Oh, put this away before it goes off.
Oh, my God, she's got explosives in there.
Ugh, this ignition thing is broken, and this timer thing isn't working. I wish I'd never got involved with these people.
He's part of an organisation.
But the ignition thing should work automatically. You just push the button.
He's got a remote control device.
This is Martindale. We're going to need backup. Let's get this street sealed off. Barry, Caroline, Tony, all units, this is Martindale. Code 9, all units. The sherbet is about to fizz.
Keep back, please. There's nothing to see. Come back in a few minutes. There should be blood and limbs all over the place by then.
Tea, coffee, cigarettes?
Now Slater has it.
Excuse me.
Oh, what
now? I need to see Martindale.
Oh, bloody hell.
I keep telling you, he's busy.
He'll want to see these.
Some kind of bunch of keys device. Well, he's not here. He's taking part in a top secret operation at a secret location somewhere.
Hey, don't ice me.
She's got a gun on him.
Let's take her out.
Yes, sir.
I'm standing here on Chestnut Avenue.
Oh, for Christ's sake!
Sydney Magnum, loss adjuster.
Sorry, no new evidence beyond this point.
Caroline?
What?
Bloke selling guns. Do we need any?
Oh, I don't know, really. I think Charlie would like a Kalashnikov.
Hey, you, stop! Give in!
All right.
Can you clear this up for me when I'm done?
Yeah, all right.
Damn. What's going on in there?
Target out of range, sir.
What the?
You're about to shoot an innocent woman.
Well, can't it wait?
I can prove Little Devils was torched by its owner, Valerie Darcy.
I'm rather busy right now. Fire when ready.
Keys. Keys used to open the shop from the outside. Keys left in the shop. Keys bearing an identity tag with the wording, if lost, please return to Valerie Darcy, 37 Bacora Drive, Tooting. It'll look messy in the press if you shoot an innocent woman.
Well, we can say she fell on the bullets.
Congratulations, all units. The drill is completed.
What?
Repeat, this drill is completed. All units return to base, sir.
What about the crowds, Gov? We might need horses and tear gas to disperse them.
No, Charlie. It's over.
Sorry, Martindale. I know how much this meant to you.
Do you? I don't think you could possibly know.
Oh, I forgot to tell you. You know that shop, Little Devils? It burnt down.
Yes, of course. Well, what do you know about it, Margaret?
Well, everyone's saying it was an insurance job. The alarm would have gone off if anyone had broken in.
An insurance job, you say? It was an insurance job. The shop was burnt as an insurance job.
Yes, are you all right?
Oh, thank God for that.
Why, what did you think it was? Arson?
No, of course not. Why would I imagine that? I mean, only a completely dedicated professional group of people who would take no risks when it comes to public safety would be selfless enough to believe that. I mean,
oh, I'm knackered. Oh. Oh, I got that cream for your itchy bottom.
What? Oh.
It's in the bathroom. What's that strange van parked outside with that big aerial on it? It's been there for ages.
Oh, really?
It's just had a pizza delivered to it. Oh, maybe we should phone the police.
No.
No, you're right. They're complete idiots. Too busy bothering innocent people. Someone should put a bomb under that police station.
Metaphorically.
What?
Well, not literally. I mean, it's just an expression, isn't it? Anyway, you go to sleep now. You must be exhausted.
Are you getting undressed or are you just going to stand there?
I might sleep in my clothes tonight. Yeah, I've got a very early start and I want to look my best.
You can't sleep in your clothes.
No, of course not.
What's the matter?
Nothing.
Well, just come to bed.
At last. Oh, yes.
Very nice.